Hello everyone. The topic of this presentation is about conjunctival incisions. The most popular conjunctival incisions are the limbal and the fornix approach. Other less commonly used types of incisions are the Swann incision and the minimally invasive strabismus surgery technique described by Dr. Mojon. The limbal incision is probably the most popular incision in Europe and in some countries all over the world. In the limbal approach, a circumferential incision is made in the conjunctiva as close as possible to the limbus. In addition, one or two radial incisions may be added to allow better exposure. The incision usually starts with a small snip at the desired upper or lower poles of the incision. The incision is then extended parallel to the limbus by blunt dissection under the conjunctiva thinning complex, followed by sharp cutting. Notice that at the limbus, both the conjunctiva and the tenon are fused together. So usually the incision cuts both of them at the same time in one layer. In some cases, you may want to add a mark on the conjunctiva along your incision lines to allow easier identification of the cut ends of the conjunctiva. This is particularly important in complicated and recurrent cases where identification of the conjunctiva at the end of surgery might not be easy. The circumferential incision is usually accompanied with one or two radial incisions at the start and at the end of the incision to facilitate exposure. Usually only a short 2 or 3 millimeter radial extension is all what is needed. But in few instances, when exposure of the very posterior part of the sclera is needed, such as in posterior sclera fixation or Faden sutures, the radial incisions are usually made longer to facilitate exposure and identification of the posterior part of the sclera. The limbal approach is very suitable for beginners because it allows better exposure and better understanding of the surgical anatomy for beginners. It also allows better exposure when too much of a posterior dissection is needed, such as that during a posterior sclera fixation suture. The limbal approach also allows better exposure in surgery for slipped and lost muscles. The limbal incision does not cause excessive traction of the conjunctiva during manipulations, so it is very suitable in elderly patients to prevent undue enlargement of the incision. And it also allows some recession of the conjunctiva whenever the conjunctiva is very tight. However, Closure of the limbal incision usually requires large number of sutures close to the limbus, which might cause some irritation to the patient. This can be reduced by using 8-0 sutures and putting the sutures in an inverted fashion to avoid irritation to the patient by the cut ends of the sutures. The sutures should also be placed in the correct anatomical place to avoid getting an unsightly scar to the patient. Improper handling of the conjunctiva might cause this disfiguring scar to the patient. The conjunctival irregularity as the limbus might also predispose to a corneal dellum formation. And if you are not taking a good care, you might cause damage and scar formation in the area of the plica and the caruncle. The second type of incisions is the fornix approach, which is more popular in the United States. The fornix incision is placed around 8 mm posterior to the limbus. They are either placed in a radial fashion or a circumferential fashion. Both types of incisions can be placed in the lower or in the upper fornix. Inferior incisions are usually used for horizontal muscles, particularly if you want to do an inferior vertical offset. They are also used for inferior rectus muscle and for inferior oblique muscle surgery. Superior incisions, on the other hand, are done for horizontal muscles, especially if you want to do a superior vertical offset of both horizontal muscles. They can also be used for superior rectus and for superior oblique muscle surgery. The main disadvantage of radial incisions is that if it extends, it will extend towards the limbus. They are preferred in adjustable sutures because of easier access to the muscle, but they should be avoided if the conjunctiva is very short to avoid this unsightly extension towards the limbus. The circumferential incisions, on the other hand, if extended, it will extend over the muscle in a swan-like type of incision. They are preferred if the conjunctiva is tight to avoid this extension to the limbus. In fornix incisions, the globe is grasped at the limbus using a fixation forceps and pulled in an oblique fashion to expose the oblique quadrant of the globe between the two muscles. You can see that there is a pink zone overlying the muscles and a white area in between. The incision should be made in the white area, not in the pink zone. The standard way of doing a fornix approach is to do a circumferential incision in the conjunctiva using a small superficial snip. The incision is usually made about 8 mm from the limbus. Once the tenon is exposed, using two locked fixation forceps, the tenon is grasped from the conjunctival opening and pulled out of the conjunctival opening. A radial incision is then made in the tenon space to expose the bare sclera. Alternatively, you can open both the conjunctiva and the tenon capsule circumferentially. You can also try to do it on your own without an assistant, by grasping the conjunctiva and then re-grasping the tenon using the same fixation forces. Once the bare area is exposed, the tenon can be cut off to allow better exposure. The fornix incisions, being small and covered by the eyelid, are cosmetically better and can be left even sutureless. In fornix incisions, there is a lower risk of anterior segment ischemia with multiple eye muscle surgeries because there is less violation of the ciliary blood vessels. In addition, there is a lower risk of loss of the limbal stem cells. The third type of incision is the Swan incision. In the Swan incision, an incision is made posterior to the muscle insertion overlying the muscle. The main disadvantage of the Swan incision is the risk of injury to the muscle or to the ciliary blood vessels during the conjunctival opening. Finally, we have the minimally invasive strabismus incision that was described by Dr. Mojon. In this technique, two small incisions are made parallel to the muscle border to allow exposure of the muscle. Thank you.